us into the great presence of the Lord. Amen. Well, we want to make welcome with us. Pastor, come on up. Let's welcome our pastor. Amen.
For there is greatness among you. There is greatness in you. There is greatness flowing to you, says God. There is greatness flowing through you. Everything you've been through is to take you to where I'm taking you to, says the Lord. So let this be a day of overwhelming rejoicing. Let this be a moment where you realize and recognize by revelation knowledge that you are standing in an open portal, that my victory is flowing to you, says God. Everything good, nothing bad, everything of victory, nothing of defeat, everything of joy, nothing of sorrow. Receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it, says the Most High, and let your rejoicing fill the earth. Extol that name. Honor that name. Beseech that name. Call on that name. Rejoice in that name. There's victory in that name. There's release in that name. There are slamming doors in that name. Thank you, Jesus. Ah, somebody needs to go eat. Somebody needs to go eight right now. Somebody needs to go eight right now. Yes. You have thought others should be in front of you. You have said others were more qualified, more talented, more gifted. You have said that others stand head and shoulders above me. You have been paralyzed by your own insignificance. But my spirit is loosed among you, says God, even this day. For I will call you from tending sheep to leading nations. I will call you from tending sheep to leading nations. I will call you from tending sheep to leading nations. For you are not insignificant. Even as David appeared, flaxen-haired and freckle-faced, even as David appeared, weak, emaciated, even as David appeared, the lesser of all of his brethren, still yet I sent my prophet, I released my spirit to take him from tending sheep to leading a nation. So shall I move upon you in this year of eight, says the Lord. For seven is rejected and eight has received the promise of my anointing. It is a new season. It is a now time for a new thing. So rejoice in it, says the Lord. An eight shout. Shout, because in eight, the sin of seven is canceled. Shout, because in eight, the distraction of seven is canceled. Shout, because in eight, the weakness of seven is canceled. Shout, shout an eight shout. Shout a linen ephod shout. Shout a shout, praise a praise. Dance a dance that makes your neighbor know you've lost your natural mind. In eight, the wait is over. You didn't hear me. In eight, the wait is over. In eight, the travail has stepped into its now time for a new thing. You didn't hear me. Run up here, Larry, Stacy. No, 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 no. I'm saying no to everything that bound me in seven. Everything that swelled me up in seven. Everything that hindered me in seven. Break! Shall break! Shall break! Break. prospering. Innate, the back of poverty. Innate, the back of poverty is broken. Nothing that hindered you in seven will bind you in eight. Manifestation of a new thing, a new you, a new wife, new children. It's the third time I can't get away from it. Come here to me. Come here to me. Come here to me. Come here to me. Everything's prophetic. That baby is a boy. You have never had a boy. It is about to be his now season. And when his now season comes, there is nothing you can do to stop it. Do you understand? There is nothing you can do to stop the now season. The birth of that boy is a prophetic sign to you, says the Lord, that I am bringing you and everything that pertains to you into your new thing. Somebody's praise him a minute. Now, I'm trying to be good. I'm trying.
Oh, praise him. Everybody, praise him. It's time to get your praise. And always, get your praise. And always, praise him.
Okay, I'm not supposed to like do this till tonight. But I wasn't supposed to do it last week or the week before. Or the week before that. You're going to just have to bear with me a little bit. So me and the Holy Ghost can get you positioned. Excuse me. Okay, just one thought. Okay, just one thought. See if you can get your spirit around this. Behold, I will do a new thing. And now it shall spring forth. Now, at this time. Now. Say now. See, when you say now, it's different than any other now you ever said. Say now. Do you feel the force behind your work? Do you feel like you got to put your head behind your hand behind your head every time you say now? 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 Now the burden is lifted. Now the victory has come. Now? 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 Now this, you've had other nows, but they're not like this now. New thing. Oh God. New thing. Say new thing. Say new thing. New thing. New thing. New thing. What thing? Whatever thing. New you. New church. New ministry. New open doors. New fulfilled visions. I don't know who that lady is with the cow neck sweater on in the gray right there. I don't know who you are. I'm going to tell you right now, you're about to receive a new thing in regard to your finances. But listen to me. New things require new seeds. What did the book of Genesis say? God said, I'm about to change everything around now. In order to do it, her seed will crush your head. New seed. New seed. Say now. Say now. Square your shoulders and see if you can get it to come out of your belly instead of out of your head and say, now. New things come in now seasons. I don't mean to quote the Bible to you. He changeth the times and the seasons. He said, behold, I do a new thing. Now, in this season, it shall spring forth. See, you all trying to have faith and do all that kind of stuff. I'm telling you, right now, it don't have anything to do with your faith. I'm going to wait till somebody in here heard me. I'm going to wait till somebody can stop thinking about how long you've been standing and lock in, because the word coming out of my belly is about to change your future. Say it's time for a new thing. Anybody in here need, anybody watching live, anybody need a new thing? I'm going to ask you again. Does anybody need a new thing? Okay, let me try to help you. I wish somebody just whisper in the Holy Ghost. I wish somebody'd understand we're in a prophetic moment. I wish somebody'd lock in on this isn't a sermon. Shout new thing. New Now season. New things don't come forth any other time than in the now season. Did anybody see any corn growing in the fields on the way here? You know why? Because it's not their now season. But guess what? Come spring. Come spring. When you do, February, you got a date? February 13th. Is that a special day or something? February 14th, Valentine's Day. I don't know, I just remembered something like that. Shout! No, no. Take 30 seconds and go 8, or I'm not telling you anything. Go 8 for a new thing. Go 8 in a now season. Behold, I shall do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. New thing.
New thing
now. New thing.
New thing
now. Go get me DJ sister. Stop. What season is it? What season is it? What season is it? What season is it? What happens now? New things can't be hindered, can't be stopped, can't be... Slap your neighbor a high five and say, excuse me, but I don't have to do nothing to get this. 'Cause it's time. No, you didn't hear me. It's time.
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 The head is crowning.
Time.
You can't time. Stop it. Look back in your past. Look back there. Look in your past. Look in your past. Look at your failures. Look at where you didn't measure up. Look at where you missed it. Look at where you were blinded and deaf and could not hear. Look back where you were chained and could not get free. But now. Let me ask you a question. What could your adversary do about your past? What could he do? What could he do? Nothing, because its season has passed. He, not you, not me, not preachers, not television, not the economy, he changeth the times and the seasons. And the devil can't do anything about your now season any more than he could do about your past. I'm getting stuff stacked up here. Tonight at 7 o'clock, if you miss it, you crazy. You crazy. 'Cause tonight we're slamming doors. We're slamming doors tonight. Slamming doors. Here's all I'm trying to tell you. It is your time. See, favor is never fair. So quit feeling all guilty about how much God is about to bless you. Because in 8, the struggle is over. No. I'm prophesying that to you. In order for it to fulfill in your life, somebody else has to pick it up, send it back to the Father, acknowledge it.
Hallelujah.
Sow the heavens. Yeah. I got too much. Shout, sow the heavens. Establish the earth. Sow the heavens. Establish the earth. Sow the heavens. Establish the earth. Everything you've sowed. I'm talking about your words. Everything you've been standing there with your shoulders squared. Some of you been confessing stuff. I got something I've been speaking into the heavens. I got stuff, man. I've been speaking into the heavens for decades. Undaunted. Immovable. Always abounding. Seeding the heavens. And I walked past the bedroom of my child the other day. At night, I go by there every night, lay my hands on the door. And I heard God say to me, I got this now. You hear me? I heard God say, you can go on, I got this now. Because it is the now season for every seed you've sown. You didn't hear me. The heavens are about to burst forth with the rain of the fulfillment of your new thing. Because God said it's time. You didn't hear me. See, if you really got it in your belly, there'd be people doubled over, falling out, running the aisles. If you really believed that everything you've sown into the heavens, God says, I got this now. I just heard him say, you've done your part, and now I will do mine. Stand still and see the salvation of your God. Could you just try to get happy about it? Your hands up. We're about to cast all our care over on the Lord. Shout, I understand.
I understand.
You got it now.
You got it now. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, oh,
oh, oh. He's got that lawsuit. Here's a sign. Walk out of here. You walk right there. Walk right. No, move back there. Move back, 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 back. Stop. The Holy Ghost says, you were singing last night where Harvest Prep beat up on Fisher and three officials. You were singing the national anthem. And you struggled just a little bit at the beginning. Never seen you struggle. And the Holy Ghost said to me, there's a hindrance in her back. Why are you shaking your head yes? Why are you shaking your head yes?
I was in a car accident right before Christmas.
The blinders come off and you see in the Holy Ghost in the now season. Faith from another world possesses your life in a narrow season. Okay, we're going to start over. We're going to start over. Okay, just track with me. Just track with me. All I'm doing is standing here. I'm telling you that last night I'm sitting in my box being nice, really nice, as I watch 7 fouls to none get called against us in the first quarter. I'm being really nice. And the Holy Ghost. Ooh, lay your hands on your belly and shout, I receive a fresh baptism in the power, in the fire, in the revelation knowledge of the Holy Ghost. Now act like you've got it. My Jesus. Minding my own business. Business. You white folk. Of course, that's where David was, wasn't it? I can't get nobody. I can't get nobody to go with me. I can't get no. I can't get. I can't get. I can't get nobody. I can't get, oh God, help him, help him, help him, help him. Pray for 15 seconds in the Holy Ghost to try to get your spirit open. Do you have a microphone? Pray in the Holy Ghost and tell the devil, you can't stop the manifestation of my miracle in my now season. Stop. David's on the backside of the desert tending sheep. I said, God, what do you want me to do about this election? He said, you don't need to worry about it. I said, why not? He said, it's a now season. Everything I try to struggle about, God says to me, I got this. I got this. Can I tell you in 2008, God has you in his hand. Oh God, Holy Ghost just said, 2008 is a bad time to move from your field.
Say it again.
You go get in the wrong field. It's not the now season over there. I'm just speaking to you prophetically. If God brought you, if there's anything I'd do, I'd hold this year. I'd hold right where I am. Did you hear what he said? Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Striving is over. Trying to make it is over. Trying to get it is over. Chasing after it is over. Searching for it is over. Behold, I do a new thing, and now it shall spring forth. My God. All right, I have to apologize. I really do.
No, I do.
You know, I was trying to explain to the executive staff the other day. You know, I know I'm not the greatest pastor in the world. No, listen, I know that. I understand that. I know who I am. You know? I'm the best one you got, but I'm not the best pastor. I don't know. I'm anointed apostolically.
Yes, sir.
That's different than just being anointed in the pastoral gift. And so at times it's kind of hard to be here, because you come out wanting the pastor who is the teacher and the lover. Right? And you spring in here and you stand up for an hour and 15 minutes listening at me. And if you're not connected spiritually, you're just standing there saying like this, back and forth. What in the world is going on? Right? I step into the prophetic. Why? Because the apostolic gift comes in and out of all the fivefold ministry office gifts. At times, I'm going to come out here and there are going to be 150 people give their lives to Jesus. And you're like, we didn't even do that. Right? At times the gifts are going to be in operation. There are other times when I'm standing in the pastoral gift and you think, what happened to him flowing in the gifts? It's a different season. And I don't know when they're coming. And I don't know when they're going. It's like the wind. You see? I don't know. I do the best I can. But if you're going to be here, you're going to have times when the finger of the prophet is right in your face. And we don't have to call him in. We're going to win souls, and we don't have to go have an evangelist in. We're going to get taught if you'd show up on Wednesday night. And you don't have to try to watch every noise there is on Christian TV to learn something. Now, I need you to understand where we are right now. I am minding my own business, sitting in my box, which I had made for me. Because I love these girls and boys. One o'clock yesterday afternoon, I was here. Bible college students out of they're not there in break or whatever. I went to the Bible college basketball game. Parents of players said, "Oh, could I meet him? I didn't know he'd come to the game." I love these young people. With all my heart, I love them. I'm proud of them. I'm proud of Mike Hutchins that graduated last year, now making straight A's at the military academy. I'm proud of that. I'm proud of my daughter on the dean's list over at Miami. I'm proud of that. I love these kids. I'm proud of them. Some of them I have to kick around a little bit. Had to grab one last night and say, "You're not living right. Need to get your life straightened out with God. But I'm trying to tell you, like David, seven other people got passed over. And then on January the 13th, 1957, with 22 inches of snow on the ground, St. Luke's Hospital in Cuyahoga County, Cleveland, Ohio. God said, you ate. Seven got passed over. God looked at Catherine Kuhlman, said, you're eight. Seven got passed over. And then God looked at you and said, you're eight. Would you act like eight? Favor's not fair. Favor's not fair. Favor's not fair. Now, wait a minute. Maybe we'll just let this morning blend into tonight. I don't know. Maybe somebody's got some Tic Tacs and a banana in their purse, and God will just multiply that thing. We all eat off of it. Stranger things have happened. Look at you. Look at the mess you were. Look how you messed up in 07. Look at it. What a mess you made of stuff. And God said, don't worry about it. I'm changing your season. Okay, watch this now. You don't have to stand it. Whoa. Okay. Minding my own business. Right? Like David. Like you. Like you. Like you. And I'm watching this girl, and the Holy Ghost says to me, she's struggling because there's something wrong in her back. Now, I'm not thinking about that till I was standing right here, and the Holy Ghost brought it to me. I could feel her behind me. Okay? Have I talked to you? That's what you have a microphone for, honey.
No, sir.
Have I talked to you?
No, sir.
Have you told me anything?
No.
Okay, why didn't I pick her? Because the Holy Ghost didn't show me her. He showed me her. Now, when I said what I said, see, we look for the spectacular and miss the supernatural. I'm not going to pass over this. I'm not going to pass over this. We could have a worldwide revival from this. Because it proves. Every person is given something to do that proves who God is. That's what your Bible says. So in this season, I'm operated. The gifts are flowing. So I can't come out here and give you your sermon and fix everything nice for you. You can sit down whenever you want, stand up whenever you want, run whenever you want, shout whenever you want, roll on the floor whenever you want. I don't care. It's a now season. It's a now season. Now watch this. And you said, you didn't tell me anything.
Nothing.
But, the Holy Ghost said, you got a problem in your back.
Yes.
And you shook your head yes.
Yes.
Why you shake your head yes?
Car accident.
You were in a car accident.
December 20th.
Did you give me a note and tell me you were in a car accident?
No, sir.
Did your friends tell me you were in a car accident?
No, sir.
Did I get a report from the pastoral care office telling me you were in an accident?
No, sir.
Do I know anything about you being in an accident?
Absolutely not.
What happened in the car accident?
I was going through an intersection and a car was turning left, crossed my lane of traffic and smacked into me.
What happened to you physically?
I hit the steering wheel, my head did, and I extended my left arm. So I had shoulder pain all around my back and down my back, just whiplash, muscle pain.
Nothing that hindered you in 07 can go with you.
Thank
into
you,
08.
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
I don't know whether you know it or not, but you got healed this morning when you were there dancing. I don't have nobody going eight right now. I don't have nobody going eight. Okay, stop her. Stop her. Okay, hey, hey, Blondie. Hey. What's her name?
Miranda.
Huh?
Miranda.
Miranda. Miranda. Miranda. Oh, wait. 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 There is a miraculous move of God coming to World Harvest Bible College in eight. There is a new thing. Oh, God. A new thing. Oh, come here, Dr. Fisher. I know you got that PhD and everything, but you're about to get something more than that. Stand right there on that step right there. Now! A new... Now! Shout! Now! Okay, wait. Okay. What's your name, honey? Huh? Tabitha, that's right. Tabitha. My problem is, when I get like this, I hear things in the spirit, and I don't know nothing naturally. It's a wonder I can stand here. Tabitha. You got your GED, didn't you? Isn't that awesome? Isn't that awesome? Isn't that awesome? Next Sunday morning, let me just tell you, next Sunday morning will be the most important, exciting, thrilling service. I'm going to share things with you next Sunday, and you're not going to be able to stay in your pew. I can't share them this Sunday because it's not the now season. I thought it was, and I had to wreck everybody's schedule. Just ask my staff. But God bless their hearts. They understand where I am right now. And they just, whatever, Pastor. What a poor little Katie. I don't know where are you, Katie? She in the back? There she is. Poor little Katie. We were working last night. What time did you bring me that last draft? Not beer. Right. What time was it? 11:30? 11:30. We worked all day yesterday on things that I have not even mentioned today. But they understand. It's a now season. And next Sunday, I'm going to freak you out, man. I am going to freak you out. Okay? Shout, new thing, now season. New thing, now season. New thing, now season. I don't have to do anything to get it. It's just showing up. It's just showing up. It's just showing up. It's just showing up. My kids' salvation is showing up. My marriage reconciliation is showing up. The healing in my body is showing up. Because all the seeds I've sown in the heavens have reached their now season. And they're about to rain down. And there ain't nothing the devil or me or anybody else can do about it. You got your GED. I mean, how many babies you got? Two? Two girls. You got two. I thought you had two. And the Holy Spirit, when I looked back there and saw you, the Holy Spirit began to deal with me that there's something you want to do in 08 in regard to your education. Is that right? I could tell you how tall he's going to be right now. I can't tell you what your name is,
But I can tell you that. Something about your education. You want to do, it's a dream in 08. What is it? You want to go to nursing
school? Nursing.
You want to get in nursing?
Yes.
Okay. Wherever you get in, where's Miss Joni? Why are you over there? Come over here. It's just the anointing.
We get home, she'll say, don't you speak to me like that.
And I just get to hide behind, oh, it's the anointing, honey. I want Miss Joni here because she intercedes for you all the time. Like I walk in and she's just praying like crazy for you. She thinks you are so beautiful. She thinks you should be a model. You're so beautiful. Anyway, wherever you get in, Miss Joni and I will pay for your first year.
Can we do that? Can we do that? Give her a really big hug.
Wait a minute. What?
You start tomorrow? She starts at Columbus State tomorrow! God's not going to be late. God's not going to be late. God's not going to be late in your new season. Somebody go away.
I know y'all are just like, I just came to Sunday morning service. When's he going to preach the sermon? I'm sorry. I really am sorry. What? They can go anywhere and get a sermon?
They can't go anywhere else.
Yeah, but some of them ain't too good. I've heard some of them. God just said, it is a now time for the church. More denominational bondage will break in 08 than the previous decade. Shout, because you know somebody bound by religion that needs to get set free. Now, you got to understand, I already got one daughter in college. Now I have two. You're right. Come over here, baby. Now I have two. Like, how are you paying for that?
The classes, but I still got to get all the book money.
So your financial aid paid for the classes. I just got a miracle of my own. It's my now season. I give stuff away, and before I get it to them, I already got it back. But you got to pay for your books.
I've been calling all weekend. I got four books, and nobody has them used, so...
You've been trying to find your books used.
Because it's cheaper.
Okay, so whichever ones you can't find used, I'll buy you new ones.
All four of them, I couldn't find them yet.
You couldn't find any of them?
No.
So you would get all new books?
Yes.
Well, a child of God shouldn't have to use hand-me-downs. Woo. Wow. Wow. I feel good, man. Oh. 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 Every anointing in my life that you've seeded the heavens for comes to you in 08. Lay your hands on him now. Quick. You have to lay your hands on him now. Miranda, get a worship song. Get a worship song. Hallelujah, Jesus. Do you feel his presence just... You can sit down, stand up, twirl like a robot. I don't care what you do. But let's worship the Lord for a minute. Worship Him. Yeah. Jesus, Jesus.
Light of the world, you stepped out in the darkness.
Didn't He do that?
Your 'cause you're all together lovely, all together worthy. You're all together wonderful, so wonderful to me.
Seated, take your Bible, open it to the first page. Be seated. Open.
Us into the great presence of the Lord. Amen. Well, we want to make welcome with us, Pastor. Come on up. Let's welcome our pastor. Amen.
For there is greatness among you. There is greatness in you. There's greatness flowing to you, says God. There is greatness flowing through you. Everything you've been through is to take you to where I'm taking you to, says the Lord. So let this be a day of overwhelming rejoicing. Let this be a moment where you realize and recognize by revelation knowledge that you are standing in an open portal, that my victory is flowing to you, says God. Everything good, nothing bad, everything of victory, nothing of defeat, everything of joy, nothing of sorrow. Receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it, says the Most High, and let your rejoicing fill the earth. Exalt that name, extol that name, honor that name, beseech that name, call on that name, rejoice in that name. There's victory in that name. There's release in that name. There are slamming doors in that name. Thank you, Jesus. Ah, somebody needs to go eat. Somebody needs to go eight right now. Somebody needs to go eight right now. a wave. Slap your neighbor a high five and say, help me, help me. I got to go eight. 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 Others should be in front of you. You have said others were more qualified, more talented, more gifted. You have said that others stand head and shoulders above me. You have been paralyzed by your own insignificance. But my spirit is loosed among you, says God, even this day. For I will call you from tending sheep to leading nations. I will call you from tending sheep to leading nations. I will call you from tending sheep to leading nations. For you are not insignificant. Even as David appeared, flaxen-haired and freckle-faced, even as David appeared, weak, emaciated, even as David appeared, the lesser of all of his brethren, still yet I sent my prophet. I released my spirit to take him from tending sheep to leading a nation. So how shall I move upon you in this year of eight, says the Lord? For seven is rejected and eight has received the promise of my anointing. It is a new season. It is a now time for a new thing. So rejoice in it, says the Lord. An eight shout. Shout, because in eight, the sin of seven is canceled. Shout, because in eight, the distraction of seven is canceled. Shout, because in eight, the weakness of seven is canceled. Shout, shout an eight shout. Shout a linen ephod shout. Shout a shout, praise a praise. Dance a dance that makes your neighbor know you've lost your natural mind. We'll be right back. In eight, the wait is over. You didn't hear me. In eight, the wait is over. In eight, the travail has stepped into its now time for a new thing. You didn't hear me. Run up here, Larry Stacy. No. I'm saying no to everything that bound me in seven. Everything that swelled me up in seven. Everything that hindered me in seven. Break! Shall break! Shall break! Break, break! Break, break! Break, break! Break, break! Break, break, break! Break, break, break! 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 Break!
Break!
Slam the door on seven. In eight, the chains break. In eight, the back of poverty. In eight, the back of poverty is broken. Nothing that hindered you in seven will bind you in eight. Manifestation of a new thing, a new you, a new wife, new children. It's the third time I can't get away from it. Come here to me. Come here to me. Come here to me. Come here to me. Everything's prophetic. That baby is a boy. You have never had a boy. It is about to be his now season. And when his now season comes, there is nothing you can do to stop it. Do you understand? There is nothing you can do to stop the now season. The birth of that boy is a prophetic sign to you, says the Lord, that I am bringing you and everything that pertains to you into your new thing. Somebody just praise him a minute. Now, I'm trying to be good. I'm trying.
Oh, praise him. Everybody, praise him. It's time to get your break and always get your break and always praise him.
Okay, I'm not supposed to like do this till tonight. But I wasn't supposed to do it last week or the week before. Or the week before that. You're going to just have to bear with me a little bit. So me and the Holy Ghost can get you positioned. Excuse me. Okay, just one thought. Okay, just one thought. See if you can get your spirit around this. Behold, I will do a new thing. And now it shall spring forth. Now, at this time. Now. Say now. See, when you say now, it's different than any other now you ever said. Say now. Do you feel the force behind your work? Do you feel like you got to put your head behind your hand behind your head every time you say now? Now. 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 Now the burden is lifted. Now the victory has come. Now. 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 Now this. You've had other nows, but they're not like this now. New thing. Oh God. New thing. Say new thing. Say new thing. New thing. New thing. New thing. What thing? Whatever thing. New you. New church. New ministry. New open doors. New fulfilled visions. I don't know who that lady is with the cow neck sweater on in the gray right there. I don't know who you are. I'm going to tell you right now, you're about to receive a new thing in regard to your finances. But listen to me. New things require new seeds. What the book of Genesis say? God said, I'm about to change everything around now. In order to do it, her seed will crush your head. New seed. New seed. Say now. Say now. Square your shoulders and see if you can get it to come out of your belly instead of out of your head and say, now. New things come in now seasons. I, I don't mean to quote the Bible to you. He changeth the times and the seasons. He said, behold, I do a new thing. Now, in this season, it shall spring forth. See, you all trying to have faith and do all that kind of stuff. I'm telling you, right now, it don't have anything to do with your faith. I'm going to wait till somebody in here heard me. I'm going to wait till somebody can stop thinking about how long you've been standing and lock in, because the word coming out of my belly is about to change your future. Oh! Say it's time for a new thing. Anybody in here need, anybody watching live, anybody need a new thing? I'm going to ask you again. Does anybody need a new thing? Okay, let me try to help you. I wish somebody just whisper in the Holy Ghost. I wish somebody'd understand we're in a prophetic moment. I wish somebody'd lock in on this isn't a sermon. Shout new thing.
New thing.
Now season.
Now season.
New things don't come forth any other time than in the now season. Did anybody see any corn growing in the fields on the way here? You know why? Because it's not their now season. But guess what? Come spring, come spring, when you do, February, you got a date? February 13th. Is that a special day or something? February 14th, Valentine's Day. I don't know. I just remembered something like that. Shout! No. No. Take 30 seconds and go 8, or I'm not telling you anything. Go 8. New thing. Go eight in a now season. Behold, I shall do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Say, new thing,
new thing,
now,
new thing,
now. Go get me BJ, sister. Stop. What season is it? What season is it? What season is it? What season is it? What happens now? New things can't be hindered, can't be stopped, can't be... Slap your neighbor a high five and say, excuse me, but I don't have to do nothing to get this. Because it's time. No, you didn't hear me. It's time.
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 The head is crowning. You can't stop it. Look back in your past. Look back there. Look in your past. Look in your past. Look at your failures. Look at where you didn't measure up. Look at where you missed it. Look at where you were blinded and deaf and could not hear. Look back where you were chained and could not get free. But now, let me ask you a question. What could your adversary do about your past? What could he do? What could he do? Nothing, because its season has passed. He, not you, not me, not preachers, not television, not the economy, he changeth the times and the seasons, and the devil can't do anything about your now season any more than he can do about your past. I'm getting stuff stacked up here. Tonight at 7 o'clock, if you miss it, you crazy. You crazy. Because tonight, we're slamming doors. We're slamming doors tonight. Slamming doors. Here's all I'm trying to tell you. It is your time. See, favor is never fair. So quit feeling all guilty about how much God is about to bless you. Because in 8, the struggle is over. No. I'm prophesying that to you. In order for it to fulfill in your life, somebody else has to pick it up, send it back to the Father, acknowledge it.
Hallelujah.
Sow the heavens. Yeah. I got too much. Shout, sow the heavens. Establish the earth. Sow the heavens. Establish the earth. Sow the heavens. Establish the earth. Everything you've sowed. I'm talking about your words. Everything you've been standing there with your shoulders squared. Some of you been confessing stuff. I got something I've been speaking into the heavens. I got stuff, man. I've been speaking into the heavens for decades. Undaunted. Immovable. Always abounding. Seeding the heavens. And I walked past the bedroom of my child the other day. At night, I go by there every night, lay my hands on the door. And I heard God say to me, I got this now. You hear me? I heard God say, you can go on, I got this now. Because it is the now season for every seed you've sown. You didn't hear me. The heavens are about to burst forth with the rain of the fulfillment of your new thing, because God said it's time. You didn't hear me. See, if you really got it in your belly, there'd be people doubled over, falling out, running the aisles. If you really believed that everything you've sown into the heavens, God says, I got this now. I just heard him say, you've done your part, and now I will do mine. Stand still and see the salvation of your God. Could you just try to get happy about it? To cast all our care over on the Lord. Shout, I understand.
I understand.
You got it now.
You got it now. Oh, 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 oh.
He's got that lawsuit. Nothing that hindered you. Here's a sign. Walk out of here. You walk right there. Walk right. No, move back there. Move back, 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 back. Stop. The Holy Ghost says, you were singing last night where Harvest Prep beat up on Fisher and three officials. You were singing the national anthem. And you struggled just a little bit at the beginning. Never seen you struggle. And the Holy Ghost said to me, there's a hindrance in her back. Why are you shaking your head yes? Why are you shaking your head yes?
I was in a car accident right before Christmas.
The blinders come off and you see in the Holy Ghost in the now season. Faith from another world possesses your life in a now season. Okay, we're going to start over. We're going to start over. Okay, just track with me. Just track with me. All I'm doing is standing here. I'm telling you that last night, I'm sitting in my box being nice. Really nice. As I watch 7 fouls to none get called against us in the first quarter. I'm being really nice. And the Holy Ghost. Ooh, lay your hands on your belly and shout, I receive a fresh baptism in the power, in the fire, in the revelation knowledge of the Holy Ghost. Now act like you got it. My Jesus. Minding my own
Business. Business. You white folk. Of course, that's where David was, wasn't it? Can't get nobody. I can't get nobody to go with me. I can't get nobody. I can't get, oh God, help him. Pray for 15 seconds in the Holy Ghost to try to get your spirit open. Do you have a microphone? Pray in the Holy Ghost and tell the devil, you can't stop the manifestation of my miracle in my now season. Stop. David's on the backside of the desert tending sheep. I said, God, what do you want me to do about this election? He said, you don't need to worry about it. I said, why not? He said, it's a now season. Everything I try to struggle about, God says to me, I got this. Can I tell you, in 2008, God has you in his hand. Oh God, Holy Ghost just said, 2008 is a bad time to move from your field. You go get in the wrong field. It's not the now season over there. I'm just speaking to you prophetically. If God brought you, if there's anything I'd do, I'd hold this year. I'd hold right where I am. Did you hear what he said? Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Striving is over. Trying to make it is over. Trying to get it is over. Chasing after it is over. Searching for it is over. Behold, I do a new thing, and now it shall spring forth. My God. All right, I have to apologize. I really do. No, I do. You know, I was trying to explain to the executive staff the other day. You know, I know I'm not the greatest pastor in the world. No, listen, I know that. I understand that. I know who I am. You know? I'm the best one you got, but I'm not the best pastor. I don't know. I'm anointed apostolically.
Yes, sir.
That's different.
Yes.
Than just being anointed in the pastoral gift.
Yes.
And so at times it's kind of hard to be here, because you come out wanting the pastor who is the teacher and the lover. Right? And you spring in here and you stand up for an hour and 15 minutes listening at me, and if you're not connected spiritually, you're just standing there saying like this, back and forth, what in the world is going on? Right? I step into the prophetic. Why? Because the apostolic gift comes in and out of all the fivefold ministry office gifts. At times, I'm going to come out here and there are going to be 150 people give their lives to Jesus. And you're like, we didn't even do that. Right? At times the gifts are going to be in operation. There are other times when I'm standing in the pastoral gift and you think, what happened to him flowing in the gifts?
It's a different season. And I don't know when they're coming. And I don't know when they're going. It's like the wind. You see? I don't know. I do the best I can. But if you're going to be here, you're going to have times when the finger of the prophet is right in your face. And we don't have to call him in. We're gonna win souls, and we don't have to go have an evangelist in. We're gonna get taught if you'd show up on Wednesday night. And you don't have to try to watch every noise there is on Christian TV to learn something. Now, I need you to understand where we are right now. I am minding my own business, sitting in my box, which I had made for me. Because I love these girls and boys. One o'clock yesterday afternoon, I was here. Bible college students out of they're not there in break or whatever. I went to the Bible college basketball game. Parents of players said, "Well, could I meet him? I didn't know he'd come to the game." I love these young people. With all my heart, I love them. I'm proud of them. I'm proud of Mike Hutchins, that graduated last year, now making straight A's at the military academy. I'm proud of that. I'm proud of my daughter on the dean's list over at Miami. I'm proud of that. I love these kids. I'm proud of them. Some of them I have to kick around a little bit. I had to grab one last night and say, "You're not living right. Need to get your life straightened out with God." But I'm trying to tell you, like David, seven other people got passed over. And then on January the 13th, 1957, with 22 inches of snow on the ground, St. Luke's Hospital in Cuyahoga County, Cleveland, Ohio, God said, "You ate." Seven got passed over. God looked at Catherine Kuhlman, said, "You're eight." Seven got passed over. And then God looked at you and said, "You're eight. Would you act like eight?" Favor's not fair. Favor's not fair. Favor's not fair. Now, wait a minute. Maybe we'll just let this morning blend into tonight. I don't know, maybe somebody's got some Tic Tacs and a banana in their purse, and God will just multiply that thing. We all eat off of it. Stranger things have happened. Look at you. Look at the mess you were. Look how you messed up in 07. Look at it. What a mess you made of stuff. And God said, "Don't worry about it. I'm changing your season." Okay, watch this now. You don't have to stand it. Whoa. Okay. Minding my own business, right? Like David, like you. Like you. Like you. And I'm watching this girl, and the Holy Ghost says to me, she's struggling because there's something wrong in her back. Now, I'm not thinking about that till I was standing right here and the Holy Ghost brought it to me. I could feel her behind me. Okay? Have I talked to you? That's what you have a microphone for, honey.
No, sir.
Have I talked to you?
No, sir.
Have you told me anything?
No.
Okay, why didn't I pick her? Because the Holy Ghost didn't show me her. He showed me her. Now, when I said what I said, see, we look for the spectacular and miss the supernatural. I'm not going to pass over this. I'm not going to pass over this. We could have a worldwide revival from this. Because it proves. Every person is given something to do that proves who God is. That's what your Bible says. So in this season, I'm operating. The gifts are flowing. So I can't come out here and give you your sermon and fix everything nice for you. You can sit down whenever you want, stand up whenever you want, run whenever you want, shout whenever you want, roll on the floor whenever you want. I don't care. It's a now season. It's a now season. Now watch this. And you said, you didn't tell me anything.
Nothing.
But, the Holy Ghost said, you got a problem in your back.
Yes.
And you shook your head yes.
Yes.
Why you shake your head yes?
Car accident.
You were in a car accident.
December 20th.
Did you give me a note and tell me you were in a car accident?
No, sir.
Did your friends tell me you were in a car accident?
No, sir.
Did I get a report from the pastoral care office telling me you were in an accident?
No, sir.
Do I know anything about you being in an accident?
Absolutely not.
What happened in the car accident?
I was going through an intersection and a car was turning left, crossed my lane of traffic and smacked into me.
What happened to you physically?
I hit the steering wheel, my head did, and I extended my left arm, so I had shoulder pain all around my back and down my back, just whiplash, muscle pain.
Nothing that hindered you in 07 can go with you into 08. I don't know whether you know it or not, but you got healed this morning when you were there dancing. I don't have nobody going 8 right now. I don't have nobody going 8. Okay, stop her. Okay, hey, Blondie. Hey, what's her name?
Miranda.
Huh?
Miranda.
Miranda. Wait. There is a miraculous move of God coming to World Harvest Bible College in 8. There is a new thing. Oh God. A new thing. Oh, come here, Dr. Fisher. I know you got that PhD and everything, but you're about to get something more than that. Stand right there on that step right there. Now! Now! Shout! Now! Okay, wait. Okay. What's your name, honey? Huh? Tabitha, that's right. Tabitha. My problem is, when I get like this, I hear things in the spirit, and I don't know nothing naturally. It's a wonder I can stand here. Tabitha. You got your GED, didn't you? Isn't that awesome? Next Sunday morning, let me just tell you, next Sunday morning will be the most important, exciting, thrilling service I'm going to share things with you next Sunday, and you're not going to be able to stay in your pew. I can't share them this Sunday because it's not the now season. I thought it was, and I had to wreck everybody's schedule.
Just ask my staff. But God bless their hearts. They understand where I am right now. And they just, whatever, Pastor. What a poor little Katie. Well, I don't know where. Where are you, Katie? She in the back? There she is. Poor little Katie. We were working last night. What time did you bring me that last draft? Not beer. Right. What time was it? 11:30? We worked all day yesterday on things that I have not even mentioned today. But they understand. It's a now season. And next Sunday, I'm going to freak you out, man. I am going to freak you out. Okay? Shout, new thing, now season. New thing, now season. New thing, now season. I don't have to do anything to get it. It's just showing up. It's just showing up. It's just showing up. It's just showing up. My kids' salvation is showing up. My marriage reconciliation is showing up. The healing in my body is showing up. Because all the seeds I've sown in the heavens have reached their now season, and they're about to rain down, and there ain't nothing the devil or me or anybody else can do about it. You got your GED. I mean, how many babies you got? Two. Two girls. You got two. I thought you had two. And the Holy Spirit, when I looked back there and saw you, the Holy Spirit began to deal with me that there's something you want to do in 08 in regard to your education. Is that right? I could tell you how tall he's going to be right now. I can't tell you what your name is, but I can tell you that. Something about your education you want to do. It's a dream in 08. What is it? You want to go to nursing school?
Nursing.
You want to get in nursing?
Yes.
Okay. Wherever you get in, where's Miss Joni? Why are you over there? Come over here. It's just the anointing.
We get home, she'll say, "Don't you speak to me like that."
And I just get to hide behind, "Oh, it's the anointing, honey." I want Miss Joni here because she intercedes for you all the time. Like I walk in and she's just praying like crazy for you. She thinks you are so beautiful. She thinks you should be a model. You're so beautiful. Anyway, wherever you get in, Miss Joni and I will pay for your first year.
Can we do that? Can we do that? Give her a really big hug. Wait a minute. What? You start tomorrow? She starts at Columbus State tomorrow! God's not going to be late. God's not going to be late. God's not going to be late in your new season. Somebody go eight. I know y'all are just like, I just came to Sunday morning service. When's he going to preach the sermon? I'm sorry. I really am sorry. What? They can go anywhere and get a sermon?
Yeah, but some of them ain't too good. I've heard some of them.